is undergoes mitotic division and go for actinic change. Then go for female gametocyte is hemitotically divided and one reception cone is formed. Here it is the nucleus divided hemitotically, one poral body is coming outside, a reception cone is formed here. A reception cone. From male gamete, there is a whip-like plagiolus are formed. There is whip-like plagiolus. See here, they having whips. So look like whips are there, na? So extensions of their body is seen. These extensions are look like whip-like extensions. This is the male gametocyte. Then whip-like extensions are seen here. They form like this, whip-like. Very very important point here is, whenever the female gamete is coming toward the male gamete, here one of the whip-like structure is shed off from the body. You observe here they having whip-like structures. They said to be as a plagiolated body. This is said to be as a plagiolated male gamete. Plagiolated male gamete. Whenever it is see the female gamete, explagellation is done. Means one of the whip is removed from the body. This phenomenon is called explagellation. Plagiola get be removed. Explagellation. Plagiola get be removed. These whip-like plagiola is moving toward the reception cone and they join at reception cone. The entire events now takes place in the lumen of crop. This is the lumen of crop. These entire things are done in the lumen of crop. Gametogony takes place in the crop. Very very important. In which area of the mosquito gametogony takes place? Crop. Lumen of the crop. Cavity of the crop. What is the thing you are observed? Male gamete, female gametes are formed here. Male gametocyte converted into female gamete. Female gametocyte is converted into functional female gamete. Functional gamete is having plagiolus present over their body. Functional female gamete is having a reception cone or fertilization cone present there. Whenever they reached it, explagellation is done. That plagiola, explagellated body, that's what it was, plagiola or whipper, is moving toward the reception cone, merged there, and formed here, merged there and formed here, that is the gamete, zygote is formed. Zygote is formed. Here, the nucleus of male gamete and the nucleus of female gamete. Nucleus of male gamete and the nucleus of female gamete are merged here. This is said to be as a synchorion. What is the meaning of syn? Syn means fusion. Chorion means nucleus. The nuclei of male gamete and the nucleus of male gamete and nucleus of female gamete are fused with each other. Both nuclei are fused here to form zygote. Synchorion is a takes place. Now, this zygote is converted somewhat whip-like animal. Somewhat whip-like animal. Whip-like stage. Diploic, not animal, sorry. It is not the animal. Protozoa is not the animal. It is extended as whip-like worm. That whip-like worm is called ovokinate or vermicule. This stage is called ovokinate. Ukinate they called ovokinate. Or it's said to be as a vermicule. Vermicule. This entire thing is done within the span of 18 to 24 hours. 18 to 24 hours. Formation of the huconite. Again, I am saying, whenever a female Anopheles mosquito is such the blood of man who is already having Plasmodium in their body, by the resulting of Golgi cycle, gametocytes are entered into the mosquito body. These gametocytes reach to the digestive tract, particularly the place called crop lumen. Within the crop lumen, they undergo gametogony. Here, in gametogony, male gametogony is said to be as multiple fission, very, very important. Female gametogony is not the example for multiple fission. Here, nucleus is divided mitotically. Number of mitotic divisions done here are 3. Flagellas are coming over there from body. Whip-like flagellas. On that time they said to be as a flagellated functional male gamete. In female gametocyte, there is a mitotic nuclear division is takes place unequally. The unequal mitotic division, the nucleus is divided into 2 nuclei. One of the nuclei is said to be as polar body. The polar body is coming outside, reception cone is formed. At reception cone, one of the whip flagella of male gamete is go for explagellation. That explagellated whip-like structure tend to move toward the female gamete and they touches as the reception cone. A reception cone, the nucleus of both get fused with each other to form zygote. At that time, the 2 nuclei are merged with each other. The phenomenon is called synchorion phenomenon. Now, this zygote is converted into long worm-like structure. That worm-like structure is the modified worm-like form of a plasmodium is called vermicule or ovokinate. The entering of these gametocytes and formation of huconite is having some time period. The time period required for the conversion of the vermicule is 18 to 24 hours. So this is about gametogony. This is about gametogony. Now go for sporogony. Go for sporogony. This vermicule, tips are very pointed, very sharp. They pierce the walls of crop. This is the crop now. This crop is having crop wall. I draw somewhat because this is the crop wall. This is the crop wall. This is the crop now. Crop is the having crop wall. This vermicule pierces this crop wall, pierces this crop wall, and they settled, they entered like this and converted into the stage called ovocyst stage. Very, very important. Ovocyst. Sir Ronald Ross, who got Nobel Prize, who working over the Plasmodium, and he identified the ovocyst stages in the crop of, that is the wall of the crop, but not in the lumen of crop he identified, observed. Sir Ronald Ross, this cycle is said to be as a Ross cycle. This is called Ross cycle. Why it is called Ross cycle means, the scientist called Sir Ronald Ross, who worked as the army doctor, military doctor in Secunderabad, he identified the stages of plasmodium called oocysts in the crop wall. In crop wall, he identified. Very important point. These vermicular oocyte, which is pierces the wall here, they entered and settled within the crop. This is the wall of crop. This is not the cavity, please. Don't misunderstand. This is the not cavity. It is the cavity. It is the body wall. This is the wall of crop. It is the wall of crop. Now, these oocysts undergoes a special phenomenon called sporogony. Previously, what I told that in a raw cycle, there is the two important headings are there. One is the gametogony, already completed, and the second one is the sporogony. Sporogony is also multiple fission process. It is also multiple fission process, sporogony. Sporogony is also multiple fission process. These oocysts undergoes a phenomenon called sporogony. According to that scientist Bano, in sporogony, first division is reduction division. Later, all divisions are mitotic. Very important bit here. Initially, according to Bano, sporogony initially starts with reduction division. Later, all divisions are mitotic. Initially, the division is reduction division. Remaining all divisions are mitotic. These oocyst undergoes nuclear division. So nuclear division is called karyogenesis. Nucleus is dead space. Then go for cytokinesis. Number of daughter individuals are formed. Here observe, the formed daughter individuals are arranged in the two tiers, two rows. This stage is called rosette stage. So here, the formed daughter individuals arranged in the two tiers. The stage is called sporocyst stage. Very important. Oocyst is converted into sporocyst. They are having so many daughter individuals. The wall gets be ruptured. Number of sporozoids will come. These sporozoids are pierces here. They pierces the gut of wall, entered into cavity called hemocoel. From there, they entered into salivary glands. I am saying whenever the gametocytes are entered into the body, male undergoes male gametogony, female undergoes female gametogony. Male gametogony is a kind of multiple fission process, where mitotically nucleus is divided and cytoplasm can be divided, prothylated body is formed. Female gametogony is not the multiple fission. In female gametogony, reception cone is formed. Male gamete, female gamete are fused. When male gamete is explanulated, one of the whip is moving toward the reception cone. That male nucleus and female nucleus are merged. Synchorion is formed. This condition is said to be as zygote condition. These zygotes is converted into a modified form called vermicular ovokinate. Time takes place for the conversion of these up from here to there, 18 to 24 hours. These ovokinate stage pierces the what of, that is the gut of crop wall, and this converted into ovocyst. These ovocysts are identified by the Sir Ronald Ross. He got Nobel Prize. The cycle is called Ross cycle. According to scientist Bano, this ovocyst nucleus, ovocyst is undergoes reduction division. Later, all divisions are mitotic. Then nucleus is divided, karyokinesis. Cytoplasm is divided, cytokinesis. The number of daughter bits are formed. This stage is said to be as the sporocyst stage, having the number of sporozoites. These sporozoites are moving out after the nuptial wall, and these sporozoites are pierces the wall of crop and entered into the hemocoelomic cavity, and finally they reach to that salivary gland, want to enter man again. The total time taken for this event is 10 to 24 days. 10 to 24 days. This entire event is taking the time is 10 to 24 days. Here 18 to 24 hours. This conversion, 18 to 24 hours. This conversion is 10 to 24 days. The resultant individuals are called sporozoites. That is about the female Anopheles mosquito life cycle.